Despite it not being the largest segment in the industry by far, the crossover segment generates a disproportionate amount of interest from us in the media and from you as a consumer as well. My analysis of this situation has led me to believe that at least part of this interest stems from the fact that, at its most basic level, a snowmobile is a vehicle designed to appeal to our most basic instinct to explore our surroundings. And the crossover snowmobile more specifically appeals to our love of things that offer a heightened level of versatility. No one wants just a coffee maker. We want a coffee maker that grinds the beans, makes espresso, and steams milk. We don't just want a sled that lets us explore groom trails. We want one that lets us explore off-trail, backcountry, and deep snow areas. The crossover segment has been, in my opinion, wrought with misrepresentation since its beginning, though. I firmly believe a crossover can't simply be a mountain sled with a trail seat or a trail sled with a deep paddle. Either of these two setups will result in a sled that is vastly better at one discipline than the other, therefore defeating the versatility of the category. We got to give credit where it's due. You can't deny that the first crossover sled in the industry was Ski-Doo's original Renegade Backcountry. But as anyone who watches Snow Tracks knows, we make no bones about our belief that for the last few seasons, the Polaris Assault has been the literal definition of what a crossover should be, blending near trail sled trail performance with near mountain sled off-trail capabilities. This season, the rest of the industry seems to be catching on and have all come to the party with their own versions of what they think a true crossover should be. And for the first time, it seems that they're all shooting for that 50-50 designation. I think what's of utmost importance for today, though, is that we take the time to figure out which of the industry's top crossover sleds is the best in terms of being great both on and off trail. Our contestants today are Ski-Doo's Backcountry XRS 850, Yamaha's Sidewinder XTX LE, Polaris's Switchback Assault 850, and Arctic Cat's Riot 800. As I said earlier, the Assault is the literal definition of a 50-50 crossover. It's got a trail front end that's 42 inches wide. Its trail seat and slightly taller bars make for a fantastic ergonomic package both sitting and standing, and Polaris's IGX 144 skid frame is the shortest of this bunch, but only by 2 inches. I've been told that 2 extra inches doesn't actually make that much of a difference. At least not when it comes to snowmobile skid frames. A 1.6 inch paddle in a 144 inch length really is more than enough to get you anywhere you might want to go, especially when paired with that awesome 850 twin under the hood. If you've ridden a Polaris 850 and you don't think it's the most impressive two-stroke snowmobile motor ever made, you need to go get yourself some counseling. But I think what's most impressive about the Switchback Assault, and we've discussed this many times in the past, is that it really doesn't require any compromises at all. On the trail, it's every bit as good as any trail sled, in fact, better than most. Yet off trail, it's uncannily capable and easy to ride. It really doesn't matter who buys an Assault, it's gonna do what they want and do it well. The new Backcountry XRS is really just a variation of the original Backcountry. The platform underneath it all is exactly the same as the Backcountry X, just with more stuff. It is interesting to note, though, that when Ski-Doo started the project to build the Backcountry X, they started with a blank canvas, opting to design both a skid frame and front suspension setup that are hybrids between trail and mountain. Out back, the C-Motion skid frame draws more of its lineage from the trail, but definitely still has some mountain mixed in. With a 16-wide track and a 1.6 paddle, the Backcountry XRS has more flotation than any other crossover sled to date. It also rides pretty good on the trail as well. No, not as good as an R-Motion trail skid, but definitely not anywhere near as bad as a T-Motion mountain skid. The XRS's adjustable KYB Pro 40 series shock package does play a big role in this. Up front, a new version of Ski-Doo's RAS3 AA arm front suspension setup blends mountain arms with trail spindles. The ski stance is adjustable from 38 to 40 inches. And this is where I think Ski-Doo missed the mark with the Backcountry XRS. The idea was that the sled would handle like a trail sled, but be maneuverable off-trail like a mountain sled. But only half of this is actually true. Thanks to the narrow ski stance, off-trail handling is definitely above average for a crossover, but it does come at the expense of on-trail handling. Ergonomically, the XRS is excellent both on and off the trail. The seat's a little bit on the short side, but it's still comfortable. The handle pull position is excellent for both sit-down and stand-up riding, and those extra-wide running boards offer almost unlimited foot placement options. You certainly can't say anything bad about Ski-Doo's familiar 850 E-Tech powerhouse under the hood, and we were very pleasantly surprised to see this model come equipped with their groundbreaking shot electric starting system. Up next in our crossover shootout is Arctic Cat's new for 2020 Riot 800. And this is a pretty interesting entry into the crossover market because Arctic Cat followed Polaris's blueprint for crossover success very closely. The Riot features a lengthened version of Arctic's slide action trail skid frame they have dubbed the Cross Action. Wrapped in a 146 by 16 paddle, this skid frame offers excellent deep snow traction and an on-trail ride that's as good, possibly even better than a standard slide action equipped trail sled. Up front, the new ARS2 double ARM setup is straight off a trail sled and is, without question, the best trail sled front end Arctic has ever made. Handling on the trail is excellent. Ride quality is also fantastic. What's interesting about this front end is that despite it being 42 inches wide, it's still really good off trail. No, not as good as a mountain front end, obviously, but for a crossover, it works really well. Ergonomically, I have both praise and complaints about the Riot. The steering post, for example, is spot on. It blends a perfect balance between seated trail riding comfort and standing off trail maneuverability. The complaint I have is with the seat itself. This is a mountain seat, and while great for off trail use, it's a very awkward seat for on trail riding. Yamaha's Sidewinder XTX LE is obviously the most powerful of these four sleds. But more than that, it is the most powerful crossover sled ever built. With 180 plus ponies on tap, you will never have to worry about running out of power. But the XTX is more than just a great big motor. This is a really capable chassis both on and off the trail. Yes, its specifications in terms of front and rear suspension are identical to the Riot. So there's not much to say here that hasn't already been said in terms of on-trail ride quality, on and off-trail handling, and overall ergonomic comfort. Still, the Sidewinder XTX is a very different sled, in part because of the power, but also because of the extra weight that comes from throwing a three-cylinder turbocharged four-stroke under the hood. What's most important to understand about the XTX is that while it is definitely the heaviest of the four, the extra power it produces does help compensate for some of it. Off-trail, the Sidewinder uses track speed to get the nose up and keep itself moving in the really deep stuff. Now that we're all on the same page in terms of what these four sleds are, we need to see which one best represents what a crossover sled truly should be, and see if any of them are capable of unseating the Switchback Assault from its throne of crossover perfection. The hybrid front and rear suspension systems on the Backcountry XRS leave it more biased to off-trail riding. This is not to say it's not a good trail sled, it definitely is, but it's not a great trail sled. If you're the type of crossover rider who spends most of your time off-trail, this is the right sled for you. The Sidewinder is an absolute beast of a snowmobile. It's shockingly fast and both rides and handles really well on the trail. Off trail, it's more capable than any other crossover class Yamaha has ever been, but you can't deny the extra weight it carries makes it a less maneuverable off trail sled. If you're the type of crossover rider who does spend most of their time on the trail, I'm pretty confident in my opinion that the Sidewinder would be a really good choice for you. This leaves us with Arctic Cat's Riot and Polaris's Assault. On the trail, the Riot rides and handles as good as any Arctic Cat trail sled. Off trail, it's light and maneuverable and can go just about anywhere. Ergonomically, it's good on the trail, but excellent off trail. In my opinion, Arctic Cat's Riot is the only new crossover sled that gets close enough to that 50-50 designation of on and off trail riding to give Polaris's Switchback Assault a real run for its money. The mountain seat is the only aspect of the Riot I don't like, but the whole crew here at Snowtrax agrees. Even with the mountain seat, it's a fantastic crossover. Yet the question still remains, is it good enough to unseat the Switchback? And the answer is that it's so close, but just not close enough. Switchback Assault is still the best crossover in the industry, for now. This season though, Arctic Cat has proven that they fully understand what crossover riders want, and that they are fully capable of delivering it.
If you like what you've just seen, click the subscribe button and comment below. And make sure you check out all of our great videos on Snowtrax TV's YouTube channel.